Liz isn't here to dance with us today, but hey, you know what? We can dance ourselves, right, Kevin? It's a beautiful morning in sunny, warm,
You forgot what?
You forgot to write this on your paper and stuff.
Oh, I did. Hold on a second. Where'd my whiteboard marker go? Yeah, oh well.
Just had it.
I did. I just had it in my hand. Oh, well, hey, everybody, welcome to IDIODC, as we're just chatting and trying to figure stuff out. Chris Van Wingerden, my wonderful, esteemed co-host and friend, is not hanging out with us today. He is taking some time off, as I did a couple weeks ago. So I'm actually also not on vacation, but traveling to take my daughter to school.
Music's too loud. There we go.
Yeah, okay, sorry, I'm turning it down, yeah. Ah, that's probably better. You know, it was even on the B level. Anyways, we have a lot of stuff to talk about today. You can hear me now, right?
Yeah, I can. Can everybody hear both of us is the question.
Yeah.
Can you all hear us? Yes. Thanks, Clara. Hi, everybody.
Perfect. So maybe we'll start this over. Hi, Kevin. How's it going?
Good morning. Hi. How are you? Good. Excellent job on the Nuggethead drawing. Let's see. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, see, this is what we're going to do today. We decided to call an audible and punt today. This is just how to draw the Nuggethead logo.
Yeah.
That's
no,
it. Just kidding.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah. Right? I didn't do too bad of a job on that. I didn't butcher you too much. We do have a lot of cool stuff that we're going to talk about today, so you guys don't roll your eyes and bail on us just yet. Have we done the proverbial "Where are you from?" and "What's the weather like?" Did I miss all that in the chat?
Yeah, we kind of did that a little while ago.
You did that, all right? Yeah.
We're down here in the sweat box of the South with the infestation army worms, and we've got folks all over the country.
Perfect, which is what we love to see. Good to see everybody in the chat today hanging out with us.
Lydia's coming from Toronto. Woo-hoo. Canadians represent.
Well, I think I saw Adam's in here. I think I saw Mark in here too. So good times anyways, good times. Yeah, while the music was too loud, I guess I better explain to folks why I'm standing up instead of sitting down like I normally am. I'm in Alabama, Auburn, Alabama. I drove my daughter out here to start her second year of college, and I am in a Holiday Inn Express. So big shout out to the Holiday Inn Express people for letting me borrow their whiteboard from their conference room so it didn't look like a hotel room.
And rearranging the entire room to look like it does.
That part I didn't.
If anybody listening, if you've ever done conferences and traveling where you were doing webinars and you're trying to attend a conference and have to do a webinar or jump on a, you know, you've destroyed your room. I have.
You're right. Well, nobody wants to see the bed in the background, right?
The one thing, gotta love them because, they have the great tables and desks and whatever you set up. It's like, all right, this is a great little workstation. I can hang out here for a couple of days. The problem is it's all shoved up in a corner against the wall. So I'm always moving it out. I kind of slide the bed over. I move it back out to the center of the room so the TV's like right there and I can watch and that's the, turn on some jams. Yeah. The cleaning, the maintenance or cleaning personnel come in the next day like, don't worry, I'll put it back.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, right. Yeah. That's the trick, though. You always, it's like camping, leave it better than the way you found it.
There you go. Yeah. Adam's got three in college in three different states. Oh my gosh, dude.
There you go. Well, I guess I do too. One, my oldest is going to Nebraska for law school, and my youngest is here in Auburn, and then my middle kid is at Arizona State University. So
you only have to drive one.
I only have to drive. Well, actually, no. So this is the funny thing. I was supposed to also drive my daughter to Nebraska in a week. So when I drive home from here, I was supposed to drive from Phoenix to Nebraska to take her to law school. But she's a big girl, and she said, "Dad, you've been driving way too much lately. I can handle it. I'll take care of it."
Or you can just meet her in Nebraska and help her unpack and then go home.
That's what my wife is doing. Yeah, my wife is flying. She's not the driver. I love the drive. It's all good.
It's all good.
Anyways, we should talk about video stuff, shouldn't we?
Let's talk about videos.
Yeah. And drawing and video. Let's draw what video looks like. Let's tell everybody first kind of what the big picture idea is and what we're going to be talking about today, the kind of level set, what we're going to cover and why we thought it was important on a drink and draw talk video.
We're going to draw a video. That's the big picture. We're going to draw on a video. No, seriously.
Drawing
on a video. So we think about, we use video a lot, right? So what can we do differently, more creative with our videos? And anybody that works with video, there's B video, B shots, different things like that. And we can do some things with video to give it a little bit more creative pizzazz. And one of the things I've been exploring and working with recently, well, one is how do we take a video? So let's say you shoot a little clip on your iPhone, 2 minutes, whatever. Nothing big, but you want to convert that to an animated GIF, and then you want to loop that somewhere in your training, maybe in the background. Let me give you an example. I'm winging it here, so I'm not winging the rest of this episode. I've got some plans, but I'm winging this thought just a minute. So let's say, it's one of those, nice sunny summer afternoons, and you got the clouds flying over, or it's one of those summer storms where the rain's, hitting the porch roof and falling off. Right? It's just one of those, I'm going to grab a clip of that video. I'm going to go just a quick natural video.
Yeah. Yep.
But maybe you want those clouds, maybe you want to use that as a background in your projects, like a background video loop. But to put a background video loop like that, that's heavy, right? That's a big file. Yep. Especially if you want it to continue to loop. So what we want to do is convert
and if you shoot it on an iPhone and you've got your iPhone set to 4K and then it becomes massive all that.
Well, stuff. And I would recommend shooting it at the highest quality level as you can, because then what we do is we take it into Photoshop. We take your video in Photoshop, not a video editing tool, and then we tweak it a little bit and we do some fun things with it. Because now we can add some filters and we can add some more layers to it. And then we can export the whole thing out as an animated GIF. We can cut the frame rate down from 30 frames a second to 12. And now we have this really cool, epic looking thing. It didn't take very long to put together. And one of those.
Okay, so first, let me stop you right there. First of all, I had no idea you could import videos into Photoshop. So tip of the day, you can do that. And two, the reason why Kevin says shooting at the highest quality you can is because you can always downgrade. You can't upsize up quality video, but you can absolutely downsize it. So shoot at the highest. So get your raw footage, your original shot at the highest quality you can, and then you can bring it down for sizes for e-learning for a multimedia production.
Yeah, I was teaching, and thank you for pointing that out, because I'm teaching a Camtasia workshop currently. And yesterday we got into a little bit longer discussion around resolution and ratio. It was a topic in the workshop, but it was a discussion that took a little bit longer than I anticipated, because it's very confusing if you don't break it down to the fundamental. Ratio and resolution are two different.
Yeah.
So anyhow, yeah. So shoot whatever you want to do. Same with your photos. Take your photos at the highest quality level. Because you can't, basically, you can't stretch a pixel. I mean, that's it. A pixel is a pixel. So we don't want to stretch it. We can shrink them, but we don't want to stretch them.
Indeed. So we got our photos going into, or videos going into Photoshop. And you're going to tell us, you're going to answer the question that just dropped into the chat as to
why we want to do that. I will tell you why. What the benefit, it's not whether one you can do, I mean, you can put it in After Effects and you can do it in any tool you want. Photoshop is just, there's one little technique that I like using Photoshop, and it's called rotoscoping. Anybody heard of that before? Anybody not know what rotoscoping is? And some of you may be Googling it really quick. Yep. So rotoscoping is basically you draw your frames on your video, and basically you recreate the video one frame at a time, but you're in control on what you want to do, so you can add more things. So think of those clouds, right? If you wanted to do the cloud and you just trace the clouds over, then you can add a flying giraffe along with your cloud. So you can add more creative things that you wouldn't normally be able to do in a typical video. So we're gonna do a little example. Show you how to do it quick.
Awesome. What time do
you have? You got about half hour? Yeah?
Yeah.
You got time.
Yep.
Rotoscoping is think of I'm trying to think of the band now. It's
Take On Me.
Take On Me. I can't think of the band's name. Look up the YouTube music video. Aha, that's it. Aha, Take On Me. That is a rotoscoping. It's probably one of the world's best rotoscoping examples in the day. The most famous, yeah. So when that video, music video came out, the technology back then, that was hand done, one frame at a time. So you think as a 30 frames per second music video, and then creatively doing all the extra to kind of get that motion, the animation effects. World class rotoscoping example. Betty Boop, that's right. Fleischman, exactly. Adam, the historian, jumping in the chat. Yeah, we're going way back with Betty Boop, aren't we? Okay.
Yeah. All right, let's jump in. Let's do something.
Let's do something.
And I did find my pen.
You did find it. Okay. See, right when I need everything coming up here, I'm not quite there. We go.
Oh, there we go. That's about as close as I can get to an idiotic mug today.
There you go, a little holiday and branding going on there at the same time.
Well, I got to give them a shout out.
Yeah, there's the video. Thank you, Wendy. Jennifer, right? Thank you. That song stuck in my head the rest of the day.
Do you need to do a screen share?
Yeah, waiting on you. Oh, is that me? Can I? No, I
didn't. That's you. Yeah, it's all you.
Sorry. Which video? So what you're going to see initially is my grandson. Have you seen my grandson?
Woohoo!
Can you see that?
Yeah, got it. Yep.
Okay, so you see this video is, I don't know if you can see, that's 13 seconds. So this is a little video where his new slide, sliding down the slide. So let's say we want to take this video and we wanted to trim it down a little bit, and we want to take all the background. We want to get rid of all this background out of the way. So what we do is we open Photoshop. In Photoshop, all you got to do is, here's the move file. So you just open the movie file, mp4.move file. Just open it in Photoshop. And open it. There you go. And it automatically creates a video timeline. So there it is. and you can play it in Photoshop just like it was in movie. Same movie. Now you've got these little control points along the way, right? Wow, isn't that cool? Check it out.
That is so cool.
Yeah, so well now we've got this, 15-second, this time, let me zoom in this timeline here and show you how this works. Photoshop's timeline is a little bit different. See the F? That stands for frames.
Okay.
So 3, 4, 5 frames, 10 frames, right? So we go all the way, it's as long as the video is. So there are, that's 12 seconds, so 12:05. But, that's hundreds and hundreds of frames, right? And if you wanted to do something per frame, you know, do something here, and that's what. So think of the AHA movie, right?
Yeah.
So just think of thousands of frames and then doing something each frame along the way. Well, we don't typically probably want to do that kind of work unless you're on a big, massive project. But we want to reduce that down. So first thing we want to do is change the frame rate. So right over here, that little tiny button right here.
Yep.
Click on that. Set timeline frame rate. And there's the current frame rate, 29.97, which is pretty common for most of the video, 1080p, 4K, kind of around that, 30 frames.
Yeah, they round it up to 30 frames per second usually. Yeah.
Yeah, so we're going to change that to like what? Let's do 12 frames per second. Bam. Now we've got a same video. Now I'm going to play that same video again. It doesn't look much different, does it? Same video, but we've reduced it down. Now what we want to do is now we can crop it down. So I'm going to start the video right about just before he takes off down here. This, like right there. Right about there, so I'm going to crop this back over here. Oops. Come on. Right about there, I guess, is good. And then the backside, let's see, we want to finish it out right about where he crashes, right about there. Let's take that all the way back to here. And now we've got a little bit more, 1 second, a little over 2 seconds. And if we wanted to, we could do that and then loop it, just boom, boom, boom. So you can have the same, that's kind of the idea. What we're going to do is do a rotoscope. Now we got our video kind of cropped, set our frame rates the way we want. If we look over here in the layer, let me pull this up so we can see it. This is our layers panel. And what Photoshop does is creates this video group right here. So that's our video and that's the timeline. So what we want to do next is add a new layer. This is the kind of confusing part, so stay with me on this. So we go to layer and then we come down here to video layers and then new blank video layer. See that over here? We have these two layers. But they're side by side on the timeline. So that's kind of confusing because if I wanted to draw on this layer, it's at the tail end. What I need to do is get it up over top of the group here. And to do that, I just take it out of the group and just slide it up here out of the group. And now you see it's two separate layers and I can put it above. There we go. Why do I keep bouncing? There we go. That's not, there we go. I want to stop it right there. There we go. Now, just for giggles, I'm going to rename this the draw layer like that. Now, here's the fun part. Now, what do I want to do creatively? Come all the way back here, and let me get my trusty dusty Wacom tablet going over here. I'm gonna zoom in.
The old Wacom.
The old Wacom. Going here. Come on. Hang on. Something's not connecting here. Okay. Now I'm on this layer. And right there. I'm going to go to my pen tool, brush tool. And I've got a kind of a dry brush going on here. And not letting me zoom in anymore. I'm kind of wondering why my zoom feature is not working. Yeah, Yeah, my zoom just broke. I can't zoom in out. You know what I'm going to do? Hey, let's try something. Let's save that as. Let's save that as the spinning wheel of death. We gotta love technology. Karen, my photo's covering up part of the area at the bottom of the screen. It's really just a layout. The photos. Wow, what's going on? We just got locked up here. What's up? Hang on.
No.
Hang on.
Everybody grab a sip of coffee while Kevin reboots or something. Adobe does bring joy to everyone, Lindy. I must say, while we're in this little break, waiting for Kevin to refresh, I only recently became an Adobe Suite member user. Never could justify the expense on my own, and so just never did it. But recently, I made the switch. And not looking back. So it's nice to be in the esteemed Adobe crowd of expert users.
Sorry about that.
All right, there he is. No worries, man. It happens. Hey, you know, we roll with the punches here on Idiotic.
Yeah, you know, it seems it's kind of one of those excuses where it's time to get a new computer, man.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
I'm waiting for the new Macs to come out this fall. I think I might.
Okay.
So we'll see. We'll see.
All right.
Okay, let's get back to where we were.
Hopefully you didn't lose your work.
No, it's still there. Yeah. I had a backup anyway. Because, you know, technology is going to mess with us at the most inopportune times. So
indeed it do.
Been doing this enough. I think we all know that having redundant backups and backups of redundancies is a wise work habit to get into.
Nice.
Because it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. You know,
exactly.
Fall, right?
So, exactly.
Anyway, where were we? Okay, so we got
here
our
we go.
We got it broken down a little bit. I think, oh, you know what? I know what happened here. I saved it, but it didn't save. So let's find that spot again where I'm gonna right about there. Okay, let's drop that down to there. Let me just get that started up there. We'll bring this back here. And that's a good spot right there. Bring that to there. And bring that to there. Okay. And then remember, we had our two, we have to bring this one layer out of the group.
Gotcha.
So that we can work on top of it, right?
Yep.
And then just make sure that layer is selected. And then we'll come up here. We're going to grab this little tool. And I got to change my brush. I lost my brush. So where my brush go? Let's go with dry media. Let's go with the ultimate charcoal pencil. Yeah, there we go. That's a good one. This, get my coffee cup out of the way because we don't want that spilling on the keyboard. We're going to bring this back. Frame one. And so I'm going to try to zoom in again. Hang on, let's see what happens. There we go. Drop this down just a little bit. Right about there. Okay, now here, this is where you don't have to be. This is not a aha, take on me type quality, right? Just do something. And I got to keep the curl, right? So we got to keep that part. And then come down here and do this. I'm just going to do this. We don't have time to do the whole thing. But here's what I would do. I would just kind of come around and do something like this. You got another little curl right there. And back up here where you were. There we go. And why is that there? Oh, come on. Then we go like this.
You can even add cute little features. Add a little curly on top.
Well, then we'll just do, Something like that. Little button nose. Like that. And it's kind of spooky, but you kind of get the idea, right? Now, what we do then was we go to the next frame. See, there's one, there's the next frame. And then we do it again. Now, the other thing is, how do I know where my previous was at? So we can come back over here and we can onion skin settings.
Ah.
So onion skin, if you're not familiar with that, is it allows you to, how many frames do you want to see before and after? So if I want to see where things are progressing, two, three frames back or two, three frames forward, I can set my skins here. So let's say we'll do this. We'll do 2x2. And we'll do that. And we've only got one, but you see the back. Now when I come in here, see how the whole video in the background kind of gets masked a little bit? But now I can see just where that one line is moving. And then I can, if I add any extra, this little curl, right? See how the curl moved? Actually, this kind of moved. Do that again. Let's go over here. Come on, I keep running off my wacky tablet over here. And then we'll come down here, and then we can come down a little farther out this way. And then you see the curl is out here now. And then the ear is over here. So you can see the line just out to the outside.
Yeah.
A little bit. We're just gonna do this quickly. So now on this side, because the head's moving, it's a little bit on the inside. There we go. We got a little curl right there. And then our eyes moved over here. A little button nose moved over here. And our little mouth moved down here. Then we go to the next frame. So now I see I set my onion skin to 2. You see that? There's 2 lines. But now you can see that where the line goes now, the head kind of comes back up a little bit. Back up in here, come around again, do a little flip.
There's a little curly cue. That's a
big flip. Like that. And we're going to do 3 frame, then I'm going to show you some other stuff.
Okay. I think people would get the idea after 3 frames when you see it in 3 frames. Yeah.
So And we go like that. Okay, so now we'll turn off onion skin. And then we'll go like this. Oh, forgot the face. Go eye. And button nose. Just quickly. See how the moves now. If I turn off,
yeah, there it goes.
If you turn off the video group, I probably should have used a different color.
Yeah, sorry, I can see it. Yeah, it's okay.
Let's see, fill the back of this. Oh, come on. There we go. Fill the back cover. There we go. Now we're going to fill this one. Should have done this beforehand. There we go. See how that works?
Yep.
And you just do the whole, you just kind of go along the whole thing and do that, which is fun. But here's the thing, what I like, the fun part about all this is, I covered the video now with this thing. I should have done the fill. There we go. One of the fun things you can do here, if you don't want the background, so what I would do is I would take out kind of this background, right? But yeah. One of the things is you can do is you can start adding more, you know, fun things going along, like, hey, I'm getting ready to go down this slide. And then let's turn that onion skin back on. So you can add, which you have more creativity. So let's say maybe these things are flying up in the air as he's getting ready to go.
And I would say, too, that one of the other benefits of being able to do this is that a lot of people say, as we've heard many times on Drink and Draw here on Idiotic, I don't know how to draw. I don't, you know, my drawing skills stink. I don't want to do this. But this makes it really easy. Like, it would probably be a lot harder for most people to think to themselves, I need a short video clip of a little baby going down a slide. Trying to just sketch that by what you think that might look like and draw the animation yourself is something that would scare a lot of people. But here,
you're just tracing the outline. Yeah, you're not really drawing so much. Harold asks, are there PS actions to do this? You know, Harold, I don't know, but I probably wouldn't even, because everything's custom, right? You're doing one frame at a time. There might be an action to set up the video, split it apart, reduce the frame rate down. You know, all of those mechanical settings, I'm sure you can create an action or get one. But when it comes down to actually creating, you know, whatever you want to visually do on each frame, that's you, right? So that's there's no predetermined action for that, because, you know, each video is different, frames are different. So what you want to draw on there. But yeah, I would think there's an action to all that preparatory, you know, setting up stuff. You could probably get one with that together. So here's some other fun things you can do. So even in here, let's go to the video layer itself. We could come in here with our eraser tool and we can take out the video. We can start, you know, we can take out the background, right? If we want. So maybe we do that first on every frame, take out the background. It's busy work, but depending, you know, it goes back to what I always refer to. The quality of the output, or the level, every time you take the level of the quality of the output up the next level, exponentially the level of effort to create that output is going to increase also. So you have to weigh the balance. What kind of output do I want to create, and how much time do I have to create it? And then that's the balance, right? But anyway,
think about this too. There's another reason why this would come in really handy, or this style being a good option, is You know, if you're worried about, I've got this great video of a baby going down a slide, but I don't want, I want the baby to be, I don't know, gender neutral, or I don't want, you know, I want there to be some diversity in the animations and whatnot. So when you take that video and you rotoscope it and turn it into an animation, now you can make it whatever color you want, whatever gender you want. You're just tracing around the whole entire thing. You can make it a very neutral, you know, and you know, piece of art.
Yeah. A lot of questions coming through. Let me see.
Yeah. Well, there were a couple and I thought we should get to. I guess we're pushing it close to our timeline. I don't know if you had another pizzazz trick that you wanted to show.
No, but I was just gonna, just one last thing. You can take the video layers. You know, we talk about working on top layer. You can take the video layer, go to the video layer, highlight it here in your layers tab. Go to the filter. Where's my video layers at? Filter gallery. And then now, if I wanted to add some effects to the video. So if I wanted to keep the video layer and the rotoscope on top, right? So if I do that water paper kind of color, we're going to lock up. There we go. So right there.
Gotcha. Okay.
So there's that. There's a couple of filters, right? So you can change the filter on each frame. So instead of the whole video, now that you got it frame at a time, I can change the frame and the video frame and draw on top, and you really create this kind of wonky, really creative stuff. You can do some cool stuff there. So
yeah.
Let me go back to
the super cool
answer
trick.
Some questions. Harold, Pat, PS Actions, we already talked about that. Adam, does it tween? No. This is manual. This is not After Effects.
Yeah.
Would copy and paste from frame to frame speed up the process? Yeah, Richard, you can do that. So if I wanted to, the only thing with copy here is you can take the lasso tool. Let's see. We'll grab this layer. We'll kind of go like this. And I get that. And I'll copy it. And then I'll come over to, let's say, this frame here. And so you can paste it like that, but then you'd have to, it's going to be the exact same frame, the one that you copied. So you might want to tweak it a little bit, just depend. So if you're doing static stuff in the background that doesn't move, then yeah, that would be great. Right? Copy, like if I want to keep that TP, or if I want to hang a different, like maybe if I want to draw this picture, but I want the picture to hang on the wall over here. Once I create that in the first frame, then just copy that across the frame. Yeah. Let's talk about export real quick. So we get it all done. You go to export. There's two ways to do it. We can do wait a minute. Hang on. Generate. That's what I'll, nope. Wait a minute. I'm looking for my render video. Where did it go? Export. I lost it. Anyway, we can go to export as. Save for web legacy.
Jessica says at the bottom.
There it is. And then we change it to GIF. And we loop it forever. And we can do a preview right here. And it's the video, but now it's a GIF. And loops forever. And then we've got our, you know, 720p kind of size going on. Anyway, look at the bottom of the, was it at the bottom of the list? Was it? I'm probably looking right at it. Generate.
What are you looking for again? In the export menu.
Export render video.
At the very bottom. Yeah, it is. At the very
bottom. Oh, there it is. All the way down there. I was looking right at it.
Thank you,
Jessica. I thought it was up higher in the thing. I'm sorry. Pretty standard stuff. You could do MP4, H.264, you know, QuickTime. You know, just here's that rate, 12 frames. You can change that. You can change the document. And then, you know, where you want to put it, and you're good. There's one.
Love it.
I know. Let's see. Hold on.
We were also going to talk about exporting this as a GIF, too. You could do the same thing as a GIF, right?
Yeah, I just showed that, didn't I?
Oh, yeah. No. Okay. Never mind. I must have been reading the chat. Sorry. Ignore me.
Let's see. Here's a... Here's one I did. It's kind of for like a correct, incorrect, kind of wonky video, interactive video. Like if you do a answer a question, you get, you know, correct or incorrect kind of thing. It's loading. Hang on. I know we're almost out of time. Harold's latest version of Photoshop. So here's a, you see the layers here.
That's a lot of layers.
Well,
I don't think GIFs can have transparent backgrounds, Adam. I think only PNGs can have that alpha channel. I could be wrong, though.
There we go.
It looks like an animation for a rock, paper, scissors interaction.
Yeah, it just kind of bounces up. Anyway.
Oh, okay, cool.
Anyway.
Kind of like, yay, you got it right.
Yeah.
One of the other questions that I saw pop up was, can you do this same kind of thing in Asia or GIMP?
GIMP, I'm not sure. What was the other tool?
Camtasia.
I've not done a rotoscope in Tampico because you don't have a drawing. You don't have the ability to draw. Because you can do, you know, shapes and annotations and things like that in Camtasia if you want to kind of tweak it that way.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
There's another cool effect I'll just bring up real quick, too. I noticed, you know, folks were asking about, you know, tracking and stuff like that. There are plugins for, I think Adobe Premiere has them. And I know Final Cut has it. And you can take an animation and pin it to a certain location. And then that way you don't have to do the rotoscoping where you move it every single frame. It will do it for you. So let's say you wanted to put like some text on the side of a building, but the camera is panning. You can put the text and make it stick right there. And even though the camera is panning, the text will look like it's stuck right in that position. And normally those are plugins and they call it tracking, I think. The plugins normally have the term tracking in them if you do a search for them. Oh, there you go. That GIF is cool.
Yeah, so this is, I just took a video of my hand. So I just set the iPhone up on a tripod and just did, you know, did and it recorded a couple little, you know, F and then, you know, another one like a down. And then went into Photoshop and created this rotoscope, and then exported an animated GIF. And you can do the transparent. This is a transparent background because in Photoshop you can create it as a, you know, as you're controlling the layers. So as I mentioned before, right? So if you want to do an animated a transparent background, remember on this layer here.
Yeah.
Or before you do this, you can come in here and erase the video. You can erase the back. There's your transparency.
You'd
have to trace around this. But what I would do before I converted it, like before I did this in the frames, I would strip out, make it an alpha channel, strip out the background first. And then otherwise you'd have to do this back, you know, you have to erase the background every frame.
Every single frame. Yeah. Well, look, Jack, thank you so much for dropping in that link. I guess GIF format does support transparency.
Yeah, it does.
I had no idea. Yeah, that's super cool link for those of you that want to check that out as well. We are at the end of our time today, Kevin. Where can people find you?
Oh, you know, in the frog room, front room over garage.
I love that.
Yeah. So yeah, Learn Nuggets out on Twitter, name Kevin Thorn out on LinkedIn, or Mr. Nuggethead on Instagram, and follow the antics of the traveling hats, Mr. Nuggethead.
The traveling hat. Yes, I do actually follow the antics of the traveling hat on Instagram. This has been a great episode, you guys. Thanks for hanging out today.
Thanks, everybody.
The last episode of the season. So we are taking the month of August off, but we will be back in September. So we're not completely done. We're just taking a little breather for August. And we will be back in September with a new lineup of guests. And but never fear, Kevin will always be a standard here on the Idiotic Show, doing drink and draw and showing some of these fantastic tips and tricks. Don't forget to join our group on LinkedIn. And gosh darn it, I'm going to miss you guys for a whole month. Kevin, thanks again, my friend.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Always fun. Next time we'll do so. I'm playing around with some new drawing tools and new techniques too. You know what we should do next time is a lettering tutorial.
Ooh, there we go. Fonts are good.
No, like hand lettering.
Oh, yes. I'm down. Let's get out of here. We love letters. All right, adios, everybody. See you next time.
Later. Bye-bye.